Zohan with MMA Viking here with Sirwan Kakai shortly after his victory at Royal Arena 2. So what do you think of your performance tonight?
I haven't seen the fight, but I won the first round, so yeah, really, I feel good, yeah.
Did you ever feel, how much did you know about your opponent? Let me ask you that first.
Seriously, I didn't know anything because he switched opponents so many times, and yeah, it was really frustrating, but at the same time, I got the experience now, because that can happen in the UFC, it can happen everywhere, they switch opponent, and I was just focused and just, whoever it is, I'm going to fight, I'm going to do my best. But I didn't know, I haven't never seen him. About 2 days ago, I saw his face, I saw his build, and I didn't know if he was a striker. They told me he's a grappler, but I don't know if he was going to swing, if he had Russian boxing, I don't know. So I just tried to have a tight guard, slow pressure, and do my thing, and surprised he shot. My coach told me he would shoot, but I wasn't ready for a shoot, and he did a good duck out there, and took my back, and I had a brisk control, and yeah, I mean, I had to look forward to this, I wanted the first round, so.
Great. Did you ever feel threatened? I think on the floor you were on top, and it...
No, I felt I'm more physically strong, and I believe in myself, but at the same time, I know how these guys do. They dare to get ground and pounded, and boom, they have an armbar. Good guys get caught in that. They get some losses, they get some wins, but the wins are always like they catch the guy's submission. So I had respect for him like that. Then I felt he was like grappling strong. He was not physically strong, but he was using all his strength all the time. So I know he can do this for more than 5 minutes or 6 minutes.
Great. And now you're exclusive with Royal Arena 2.
Yeah.
And they have a fight card, I think, another fight card later in this year. Is the plan to get back?
Yeah. And I will be on the December card.
Okay.
I really, really hope they will focus more on me and maybe more high rank opponent. Maybe I really hope for an American wrestler or something. Because I'm tired of fighting European guys and they always have the same style. And I think I'm going to face a lot of Americans and more wrestling background in the UFC, and that's what I want to do.
Great. So, yeah, really in Europe, I think you're kind of standing alone as one of the top guys outside of the UFC, if not the top bantamweight. How many fights do you think you need to get there, or do you just keep trying to work with now Royal Arena and get the best opponent you can?
Seriously, I think UFC already had the eyes on me, and I think they had the eyes on me for like 1 year almost, if not more. But the thing is, the tournament is full, the weight class is full, and they're taking guys still, but all the guys are short notice, and it never ends because someone gets hurt, short notice, and they cannot take me because 2 months paperwork. But hopefully, I just keep winning and good things happen. So. I get better every day, and I feel I'm getting mentally stronger, and I feel I'm ready for UFC, and I think I can beat anybody in the world, I'm just going to keep winning.
Great, so are you going to go back to Sweden after this for a little bit, or are you going to head straight back to ATT Florida?
I need to go back to ATT. I'm going to be here for 1 week maybe, and go back to ATT. Of course, I wish I could train at my home gym, GBG MMA. But a few guys here really, really need my help for sparring, so I need to get back and spar them and get back to work.
Great. Well, congratulations, and we look forward to seeing you fight again. Thank you.